In this video, we're going to have a look at Google Analytics Attribution Reports. Now, what attribution reports do is they give you the ability to compare different attribution models so that you can have a better understanding of how your advertising investment is working. Over time, this enables better budget allocation across your different marketing channels. An attribution model is a rule or a set of rules that determines how credit for a sale or conversion is assigned to a channel within the conversion path. The attribution model for Google Analytics that's most used is the last click attribution. But there are other models that are available in Google Analytics through the model comparison tool. So how do we get into the model comparison tool? Well, in our Google Analytics, under our reporting, we scroll down to conversions, and then down to attribution. This is where we find our model comparison. Now, as I mentioned, last interaction or last click is the default setting in Google Analytics. Now, the last interaction model attributes 100% of the conversion value to the last channel which the customer interacted with before converting. So when is this useful? Well, if your ads and campaigns are designed to attract people at the moment of purchase, or your business is primarily transactional with a sales cycle that does not involve a consideration phase, then the last interaction may be appropriate for your circumstances. But we have other options available. So if we click our drop-down tab, we can choose last non-click. Now, last non-click model ignores direct traffic and attributes 100% of the conversion value to the last channel that the customer clicked through before buying or converting. Google Analytics uses this model by default when attributing conversion value in non-multi-channel funnel reports. This could be useful if you consider direct traffic. So that's traffic that comes from people who have already saved you as a favorite or directly type in your website address. If you consider that traffic to be already won, then you may want to filter that out and not factor it in. So that's where direct or last non-direct click would come in handy. Now the next option that we have is last AdWords click. This model attributes 100% of the conversion value to the most recent AdWords ad that the customer clicked on before buying or converting. And this obviously would be useful if you